So why can a flat pizza box on your roof talk to space and pull a 4K stream while you're miles from the nearest cell tower? Short answer, three hops, smart antennas, and space lasers. Long answer, grab a flashlight, we're going sky fishing. No, it's not magic. Okay, that was a lie. It's delightfully complicated. By the end of this video, you'll be able to explain Starlink in one breath. It's a three-hop relay first between your home dish and a low Earth orbit satellite, then from that satellite to a ground gateway, and, when needed, between satellites themselves using laser links, so data takes shorter, straighter, smarter paths. We'll keep it jargon light and metaphor heavy. How the dish aims without spinning, why latency feels normal human instead of moon mission, how handoffs work while everything moves, and what the whole phone talking to a satellite thing actually means. Hop one, between your home and the satellite. That roof panel isn't a wobbly TV dish, it's a phased array, hundreds of tiny antennas acting together so the radio beam turns electronically. Imagine a flashlight whose beam can swivel without your hand moving. Your dish paints a tight cone of radio up to a satellite a few hundred kilometers overhead. The satellite paints one back down. Close range means quick back and forth. Hop two. Between the satellite and the ground gateway? Satellites don't contain the internet. They hand your data down to special ground stations that are plugged into fiber backbones. Think of this like a space to Ethernet drop. Fatter, higher frequency radio? Pipes shuttle lots of bits to the nearest good on-ramp? Hop three. Between one satellite and another satellite, when there's no convenient gateway below open ocean, polar routes satellites pass your data across space with lasers. Not pew-pew, invisible, super-precise beams that behave like fiber in a vacuum, hopping across several satellites until one is over an ideal gateway. Straighter lines, fewer detours. Cool, except those satellites are moving. So why doesn't your video call fall apart every few minutes? Near old-school TV sats sit 36,000 kilometers up. Starlink hangs just hundreds of kilometers above you. Shorter path means less waiting. Your clicks don't need a passport stamp. Straight. With laser links, data often travels straighter across the planet than it would through undersea cables that snake along coastlines. Vacuum paths don't care about mountain ranges or awkward borders. Local. The network can drop your traffic into the internet at the closest capable gateway, not one on the other side of the continent. Fewer scenic routes, fewer spinning wheels. Fast is nice. Stable is nicer. How do you stay online when your relay in the sky keeps changing every few minutes? Phased array tracking. The dish steers its beam electronically to follow the best satellite right now, while pre-aiming a second beam to the next satellite. When it switches, it's a crossfade, not a hard cut. Smart handoffs. Behind the scenes, routing systems constantly predict which satellite and which gateway will be best in the next moments and move your packets accordingly. Air traffic control for data. Weather smarts. Higher frequency links can get rain-soaked, rain-fade. The network fights back with link margin, adaptive coding, and rerouting via lasers if a local path gets grumpy. Storms happen. The goal is to bend, not break. Neat. What's new lately and what's up with phones talking directly to satellites? Gen 2 capacity. Newer satellites carry beefier phased arrays and fatter backhaul, which means more total capacity per satellite. Translation, better performance at dinnertime rush and in busy cells. Direct to cell. The idea is to let a satellite act like a cell tower so a regular LTE phone can talk to it. No add-on case, no weird app. The hard parts are predictable. Tiny phone power, fast satellite motion, and tight spectrum rules. Early demos focus on basic texting, voice, data expand as radios and rules line up, and yes, spectrum is scarce. That scarcity is exactly why engineers treat every hertz like diamonds. Let's tell it backwards, because that's weirdly satisfying. Your video plays because your speaker got electricity from your device, which got data from a gateway, which fell out of a satellite, which got it via lasers or through another gateway, which first heard your request from your roof dish that was staring at it like a hawk. Now tell the story forward again, and you've got Starlink in a nutshell. Same road, other direction. Starlink in one line. Three hops from your home to a satellite, from that satellite to a gateway, and from one satellite to another satellite. glued together by beam-steering antennas and smart routing, with space lasers acting like invisible fiber. It feels fast because it's near, straight, and local. It stays up because the network thinks ahead and routes around trouble. And the phone-to-sat horizon? That's the moment the sky becomes your backup signal. Where would you try satellite texting first? Mountains, ocean, or your basement? Tell me below. If this made space internet make sense, tap like and subscribe. Next time, we'll pit space lasers versus undersea fiber and see who actually wins.